The vast majority of today's human-machine interfaces use either flat surfaces with touch sensing or mechanical inputs. In this work, we explore an intermediary approach we call Surface I/O. Surface I/O offers many of the manufacturing and physical robustness benefits of flat touch interfaces, but with some of the tactile and aesthetic qualities of mechanical interfaces. More specifically, our approach functionalizes the surface of objects, allowing them to offer haptic affordances without mechanical components, while simultaneously enabling user input tracking, all in one solid piece of plastic. This requires three scales of surface geometry working in tandem. First are macro-scale surface features, between roughly 5 cm and 1 mm. In this example device, we have a valley that captures the finger and a track-like feature, as well as small vertical lines that act as detents. At our meso-scale, between roughly 1 mm and 200 micrometers in size, repeated features can create textures that can be felt when translating a finger across the surface. Finally, micro-scale features below 200 micrometers cannot be readily felt by the finger, but create vibrations that can be sensed and used to drive interactive functions. Here's the signal of a finger swiping forward. Note that we use different ratios of smooth and vibratory textures punctuated by detents in order to track the position of the finger. Surface I/O can bring particular value to applications where the visual load is high and components must be durable. It can also simplify designs, such as the multi-material and multi-process mechanical buttons on this Alexa Echo, with an entirely solid and inexpensive single piece of plastic. While we prototyped our designs using 3D printers and laser cutters, our technique is applicable to mass production methods, including injection molding and stamping, enabling goods with new levels of interactivity. For full implementation and evaluation details, please refer to our paper.